Hi, I'm Rachel East from the Savage Branch of the Howard County Library System. I'm here to talk to you today about this book, Two Truths and a Lie. It's alive! Two Truths and a Lie is also the name of a game where I tell you three things. Two of them are true, and one of them is a lie. If you can guess which one is a lie, then you win. Now, this book is nonfiction, which means it should contain things like information, facts, stories about things that really happened. Everything in this book should be true, but it isn't. This book is divided into chapters that each contain three stories. Two of the stories are true, and one of them is completely made up. And all the stories are about outrageous things. You may end up thinking all three of them are lies. But the answers are in the back, so you can test your detective skills. In fact, I'm going to test all of you right now. I'm going to tell you the stories from one of the chapters. Two of them are real, and one of them is a lie. So let's see if you can figure out which one. Now, my first story is about an octopus. Now, this is no ordinary octopus. This octopus doesn't live in the water. Instead, it lives in trees. The Pacific Northwest tree octopus was discovered in 1998, and it lives deep in the woods of Washington State. It only goes into the water to lay its eggs or to cool off on very hot days. The rest of the time, it uses its powerful suckers to cling to the branches of the trees, slinking down at night to feast on frogs and rodents. By day, it uses its camouflage to blend in with the leaves, changing its color just like an octopus in the ocean would do. So what do you think? Was that true? Or was it a lie? Well, let's hear the next story. This one is about Mike the Headless Chicken. That's right, I said headless chicken. Mike started life as just an ordinary rooster until the day came when it was time for him to become, well, dinner. But when Mike lost his head, he didn't die. The farmer found him running around the yard the next day, pecking at the ground with his stump and even trying to crow. The farmer was so amazed, he decided to do everything he could to try to keep Mike alive. And he succeeded. For an entire year and a half, Mike the Headless Chicken lived without a head. He became a local celebrity, and even now, more than 70 years later, they still hold festivals in his name, and he has his own statue. So what do you think? Was that true, or was that a lie? Well, we have one more story. This one is about dragons. Now, dragons definitely aren't real, right? Well, these tiny sea dragons are. They're called olms, and they live in caves deep on the bottom of the ocean floor. It's so dark in these caves that the olms don't even have eyes. Instead, they hunt their prey using a special sixth sense that can detect the electric waves of passing animals. But food in these caves is so scarce that the olms may not eat for as much as 10 years at a time. Can you imagine going 10 years without food? I can't go more than 10 hours. And just like mythical dragons, olms can live a very long time, up to 100 years. They're considered a national treasure, and they even have their image printed on money. So what do you think? Which one of these stories is the lie? Is it tree octopuses, Mike the Headless Chicken, or tiny sea dragons? If you said tree octopuses, then you are correct. That is the lie. Mike the Headless Chicken and tiny sea dragons are real. And that's just one of the chapters in this outrageous book. If you read it, you'll hear about things like flowers that smell like dead bodies, two children who found a dinosaur in their backyard, a man who survived a head transplant, and a remote control for your brain, and so much more. But which of these stories are true and which are lies? Well, you'll have to read Two Truths and a Lie, It's Alive, to find out the answer. And if you like it, there are more books in this series, so you can keep those detective skills sharp.